Good morning, student. Today I am going to deal with you English reader, chapter 18, The Clock. So, students, this is a poem, or we can say rhyme. So, students, have you ever seen a clock? I think most of you have seen it because it is available in everybody's house, and this is very common. So now let us start this poem. There's a neat little clock. In the schoolroom it stands, and it points to the time with its two little hands. And may we like the clock, keep our face clean and bright, with hands ever ready to do what is right. So, this poem tells about a clock. And this child says that there is a little clock in his schoolroom. So, student, what do you mean by schoolroom? It means classroom. The rooms on school is known as classroom. So we can easily say that schoolroom means classroom. So the clock which is hanged on the schoolroom and which stand on the classroom point the correct time with its two little hands. And after that, he wishes that like the clock, he may keep his face clean and bright and do correct thing in his life and can achieve big. Ye poem ek clock ke bare mein hai. और ये क्लॉक कहाँ लगी है? ये स्कूल रूम में, मतलब क्लास रूम में लगी है. इसके दो छोटे हाथों से हमें ये करेक्ट टाइम बताते हैं. और फिर ये बॉय बोलता है कि मैं भी क्लॉक की तरह क्लीन एंड ब्राइट दिखना चाहता हूँ और अपनी लाइफ में कुछ अच्छा करना चाहता हूँ, कुछ बड़ा अचीव करना चाहता हूँ. सो स्टूडेंट, आई थिंक यू अंडरस्टूड दिस पोयम. दिस इज वेरी इजी पोयम. सो स्टूडेंट्स, देयर आर सम हार्ड वर्ड्स इन दिस पोयम दैट आर क्लॉक, स्टैंड्स, पॉइंट्स, ब्राइट एंड लास्ट राइम. Now come to exercises. In this poem, there is no question answers. Now come to question number B. Fill in the blanks with words from the poem. Here are some filler and we have to fill the blanks with the words which are given the poem. Now come to question number 1. The two words used to describe the clock are dash and dash. Here we have to write two words which describe the clock. The neat and little. So write here neat and little. Question number 2. The clock is in the dash. So where the clock stand? At school room. So write here school room. Question number 3. The clock uses dash to tell the time. what the clock uses to tell us time? It uses its two hands, two little hands. So right here, two hands. Next, question number 4. Our faces should be dash and dash. Our faces should be clean and bright. Question number 5. Our hands should be dash to do what is dash. Our hands should be ready to do what is right. Now fill up is completed. Now come to question number C. Complete the sentences with the names of the different parts of the body. The given picture will help you. Here are some pictures given along with the all question and through this picture we have to complete this sentences. So come to one number. The clock has a dash just like you. Here we can see the picture of face. So in this blank space, face. Right here, face. Now question number 2. Chairs have dash and so do you. So in this picture, what we can see? We can see that there is arms. So right here, arms. Question 3. Dogs have dash and so do kites. In this question, it is telling that dogs have dash and so do kites. So here we have to tell the part of dog's body through which they shake their body part. It is tail. But students, see that the question is coming about dogs, not about one dog. So here we have to write tails. Question number 4. Did you know that a ruler has dash? Here we can see the picture of feet. So right here, feet. Question number 5. Our desk has 4 dash. While you have 2 legs. Right here, legs. As we can see in the picture. So, our desk has 4 legs while you have 2. Now, this question is completed. Now, your chapter is also completed. Now, your homework is draw a clock. Write the poem, The Clock. Write the hard words. Okay, students? And all this you have to do in your English notebook. Thank you.